Greetings, trombonist at large. I am the Vagrant Trombone, and I'm here today to talk to you about my trombone stand collection. Now, I probably have almost as many trombone stands as I've had trombones over the years. Many of them have died and gone away. I've tried all different kinds, from expensive to cheap and chintzy. Recently, I had to purchase a trombone stand that I really don't care for. It's a design that I don't like, but I needed it. And I'll get to that later. That's a story for a little bit later. But in the meantime, I just thought, might as well talk about all these different trombone stands that I've had. Now, the first trombone stand that I had was this trombone stand right here. It's from France, and it's a very good trombone stand and very stable. Has a nice wide base, and it's very adjustable. This knob goes up into the throat of the bell and can stabilize the horn really nicely. The problem is, if you put that up too high, it can get caught in your bell, and the only way to get it out is to take off the tuning slide and poke it out with a rod. Fortunately, that's not too complicated, but you always want to adjust that so that there's a little bit of play so that the moisture can get around it and doesn't get stuck. The thing I don't like about it is bango, the slidey onto the edge of the support brace. Now this next trombone stand is a 1930s era trombone stand. It's a stand that I acquired, that I was gifted from a friend because I play in a 1920s band, and it looks just looks more authentic on stage, because the stand that I typically use is this in the bell stand, but I'll talk about that in a minute. So this stand has the same foibles as this stand, except it also has a very narrow gate across the bottom. It works really well, but the problem with it is it almost works too well, because it's a pinchy to fingers kind of situation here if you're not careful. So I don't like using that one too much. This stand over here was a super cheap. I think this stand cost $8. I bought the accessory shelf, which cost more than the stand. But why did I get this stand? I got this stand because this one is spring-loaded. Yes, that is spring-loaded trombone stand. And why did I get a spring-loaded trombone stand, you may ask? Well, it's because I use it with my nice little E-flat alto trombone. And the E-flat alto trombone fits very nicely over the top of that stand. The other stands here, you can see, they go up too far into the throat of the bell, and they can get stuck. So having the bell support on the bottom on the spring helps that trombone not get caught on that stand. This stand is not very robustly made. I don't think that it's going to survive very long. It's kind of cheap on the bottom, but it does a good job. I was actually impressed that it was as good as it was for $8. And it's going to last forever with my alto trombone, because I hardly ever use that instrument, so I hardly ever need to take that stand apart. And now we come to the stands that I use the most often. And the stand I use the most often are these Hamilton trombone stands. These Hamilton trombone stands are the tried and true. They've been around forever. Well, not forever. That one's been around forever. These have been around for quite some time. And as a test of longevity is this one right here. This is the first trombone stand that I had after the one from France. And it's probably from 1976. Now, it's undergone some surgery since then. This cup was originally made out of some kind of a soft rubber with a metal plate underneath, and as the rubber wore out, it left the metal plate exposed, and this rubber tip just would crumble into nothing and then be an exposed tube here. And a lot of guys will put cloth or something on this. I just use an old shop rag. I tried using baby diapers for a while. I actually had some baby diapers, but they were too thick. So one time I picked up my horn and the diaper stayed up inside the bell, and I started playing wah, and of course the diaper fell on the floor and everybody in the audience had a good laugh. Well, don't let that be you. So, if you're going to put something over the top of the stand, make sure that it's something that is either going to, you know, isn't going to get caught in your bell, or that you will be able to, it's long enough that you can tie it down. Some people use a sock. If you're going to use a sock, buy a new sock. And I recommend black tube socks. And I could tell a story about that, but maybe I'll do that in a minute. You don't want to be sitting next to somebody. No one wants to stick their dirty sock up your trombone bell. So don't have them sitting next to your dirty sock on your trombone bell. The Manhasset stands also have another issue, if you don't cover them, that this ring will stick to the finish of your horn and leave a nice ring on the inside of your bell. You'll see a lot of guys' horns that have that ring on them from having this stick and damage the finish. These screws do strip out. There's a little belaying pin inside that keeps the pin from coming all the way out, the screw from coming all the way out on these, not Manhasset, these are Hamilton trombone stands. On the Hamilton trombone stands, and fortunately, Hamilton will send you replacement parts. That's how I got this, that's how I got the tip, that's how I got both of these, because I see some guys would just put like a hose clamp on there and it works, but unless you're playing an industrial gig, you don't want hose clamps holding your trombone stand together. It's just don't do that. And that gets us to this stand, which is the stand that I use the most when I have to travel. These are the stands that I keep my horns on most often, but this is the stand that I really take with me to almost all of my gigs. And the reason why is because it's very convenient in the bell trombone trombone stand. It has some problems too. It's got this nice rubber tip on the end which you have to push in to be able to lengthen the stand. The problem with it is it can pop off, and if it pops off, you can't lengthen your trombone stand, which makes it pretty useless. There's another problem with it is it's covered with this nice soft velour-y stuff, but the velour tends to chip off, and that can be a problem too. I don't expect this trombone stand to be particularly durable or last a terribly long time, yet it was fairly expensive. Another problem with the in-the-bell stand is when I put the stand in my bell and I carry it in my case, the case is kind of like the Titanic right before it snapped in half. So it's a little too heavy, but it's still nice and comfortable, and I don't have any problems with it pinching my fingers. There's no way to pinch my fingers. Well, with the Hamiltons, oftentimes they will pinch your fingers, or like those old trombone stands. You can get pinched or they catch on things. This really doesn't do that. And it's nicely rubberized and coated, and it's been a good stand. I've had that for a couple of years now, and I like it. The last trombone stand I have is a stand that I don't really care for, but I felt the need to have it because it's the only trombone stand in this collection which does not go inside the bell. And I play with a rock band once in a while, and I have some other gigs where I like to use a clip-on mic. Well, the problem with the clip-on mic is it will catch on the lip of this of the bell support and make a terrible noise, and everybody hates you when that happens. The sound guy doesn't like you, and he turns you off, and then nobody hears your beautiful sonorous tones the rest of the night. So I got this Hercules stand. Now, I like the Hercules stand. It's very robust. I like the construction of the Hercules stand. It's a very robust design. But what I don't like about the Hercules stand, the phone is ringing once again, is that all the weight of the horn is resting on this hand brace for my slide. There's no way to adjust the length of this to be able to support it on the hand brace up here. It's all on the slide brace on the hand. So that is a problem. And it can be a little tricky getting the horn off of it as well. It is adjustable from side to side so that you can put a larger trombone on it, but really I wouldn't leave my trombone on this stand for a long period of time, only because I don't want all the weight of my horn sitting on the hand brace. One of the things that I like about the Hamilton stands is also that when my trombone is on it, it'll clear the leg of the stand itself. I had a trombone stand that I bought for a cruise ship that I was on, and I was on a guest band on this cruise ship. I was playing bass trombone, and I brought my Hamilton stand, and it didn't seem like my horn was real safe when the ship would rock. So I got one of these really heavy duty trombone stands for my bass trombone, but the bass was so wide when it was fully extended that it was in the way, under my feet, my mutes. It was bugging the guy sitting next to me. So I would try to make it smaller, and then I would end up with the issue of my trombone hitting the legs of the stand, and I didn't like that either. And eventually, the screws started to strip out on that, and I was pretty much done with the stand anyway, but then a car drove over it, and it died a very unpleasant death. The horn that it was with was rescuable, but the stand was a total loss, and I was not upset too much about the loss of the stand. But that's about it for trombone stands. One of the things about these Hamilton stands also is that this is a newer design with the different handles on it, is not only can these screws strip out, but when you get them brand new, this part will be way up here at the top. That's so that it fits in the box. Do yourself a favor when you get one of these and get an Allen wrench, loosen up that screw and move this down so that you've got plenty of support going up into the throat of your bell. Don't make it so much that you can't get this high enough to be able to get your trombone to clear the braces, but you certainly can lower this down. I've seen guys who don't do that, and they're way up here, and they put the trombone on it, and it just looks like it's teetering on the brink of disaster. So don't do that to yourself. And I had a story I was going to tell, but I guess that's a story for another time. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye. Ha-ha! Story for another time. I remembered. I was on a gig on a television show, and we were told to wear a black tuxedo. Well, the guy playing trombone next to me, he came to the gig, and he was wearing his black tuxedo, but for some reason, he was wearing white shoes and white socks. White tennis shoes and white socks. I don't know if he thought he was performing for the Canadian Brass or what, but fortunately for him, he had a Hamilton trombone stand that he had bought clean black tube socks for. So he had one tube sock on the stand, and he had the other tube sock wrapped up in his case. He was going to use it to clean his horn or whatever, or just because you only need one sock. But fortunately, he was able to use those black socks, and they were able to stretch far enough over his tennis shoes that he didn't have to do anything about his white shoes. Because when you're on a TV show, the gaffs will come around, and if they don't like something, if you're wearing white shoes, like for example, they will come over with black spray paint, and they will just paint them black. And it would have, of course, ruined his shoes, and he would have been sitting there with gummy black shoes. And, yeah, you don't want that to happen to you. So, another reason to use clean black tube socks is in the event you forget your shoes, you can stretch your tube sock over them. Hey!